Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. All right, we're going to do this age problem, which I just think of as a puzzle. Okay, don't think of it as a word problem, it's a puzzle. The sum of the ages of an old dresser and a new dresser is 21. Actually, 21 years, I think is what that means. 9 years from now, the age of the new dresser will be the same as the age the old dresser was 8 years ago. Find the present age of each dresser. Okay, what's a little bit different about this problem is that there are really three time frames. Right now, their ages add up to 21. Then it talks about something about the new dresser 9 years ago, and it's also discussing the old dresser 8 years ago. So there's three different time frames in here. So let's do a little chart to try to keep this information organized. So we've got the age. I'm just going to put of the new and the old. Okay, and you know I'm talking about a dresser. And their current age, so right now, how old they are. And let's see. One of the other time frames is 9 years from now. I'm going to write that as in 9 years. And the other time frame is, I see, 8 years ago. Now we may not have to fill in all of these columns either. So let's see. First piece of information. The sum of the ages of an old dresser and a new dresser is 21. Okay, so right now we know these ages add up to 21, and I don't know either age. So let's let one of them be X. What would the age of the old one be if the new one was X? So you have to think X plus what adds up to 21. That's the big question of the day. X plus what is 21? You could just subtract X from both sides. 21 minus x, so this has got to be 21 minus x. So if you added x plus 21 minus x, you do really get 21, right? So hopefully that works for you. Now, you could have let x be the age of the old dresser. It depends where you want to put your x. But one of them is going to be have to be x, the other one will be 21 minus x. All right, now let's look up to the problem again. 9 years ago, I'm sorry. 9 years from now, the age of the new dresser. Okay, so we're going to have to know the age of the new dresser 9 years from now. So let's see. We're going to need to know the age of the new dresser. Here's the new dresser not in 9 years. So if it's X years right now, how old will that be in 9 years? Think about what you would do to your age to figure out how old you would be in 9 years. You would add nine. Now, nowhere in this problem does it say anything about the old dresser in 9 years, so I don't have to fill this part in here. You could figure it out, or you could just sort of leave it blank. Oops, I'm not going to put an X. You don't want to confuse that. You could just leave it blank. All right, now, it also discusses the old dresser's age 8 years ago. That's something else that is in this problem, the old dresser's age 8 years ago. So if the old dresser right now is 21 minus x, how would you figure out how old you were 8 years ago? What would you do? You would subtract 8. So the old dresser is currently 21 minus x. So you're going to have to subtract 8. So what does this give if I simplify it? 21 minus x minus 8, I've got to do the 21 minus 8, which is 13 minus x. Or you could write that as negative x plus 13. Okay, now let's read the problem again. 9 years from now, the age of the new dresser. Okay, so first of all, what's it talking about? The age of the new dresser 9 years from now is right there. So what it's saying? That, which is the age of the new dresser 9 years from now, will be the same as, all right, equals. It will be the same as the age the old dresser was 8 years ago. All right, now where is that? That's the age of the old dresser 8 years ago. So x plus 9, the age of the new dresser 9 years from now, is the same as the age of the old dresser 8 years ago. And that's the equation. Puzzling. Didn't I say it was just like a puzzle? So now we just want to solve this. Why don't you put the video on pause and go ahead and finish solving it and see if you could figure out what the ages of each is right now. All right, so let's see. I'm going to put the variables on the left. I'm going to add x to both sides and I'm going to subtract 9 from both sides. So we're going to get 2x equals 4. And divide both sides by 2. We get x is 2. Whoops. Right, now what did x stand for? X stood for, look at our chart. This is where we defined our variable on this chart. X is how old the new, what was it, a dresser? The new dresser is right now. So this is telling us if x is 2, the new dresser. Is 2. And so then how old is the old dresser right now? It'd be 21 minus 2 because we wanted the ages right now, the sum of the ages is 21. So that was the first piece of information right here. The sum of the ages of an old dresser and a new dresser is 21. So it seems to reason their present ages right here would be 2 and 19. But of course, we're going to check our answers. We've got to make sure the rest of the problem makes sense given that these are their ages. So let's do that now. All right, so here's our problem, and this is what we got for our answer, right? After we solve for x. So then the question is, does that check? Well, first of all, 2 and 19 does add up to 21. That's the first sentence. The sum of the ages is 21. Okay, so that part makes sense. But it says 9 years from now, the age of the new dresser. Okay, well, what is the age of the new dresser in 9 years? So in 9 years, the new dresser would be how old? Okay, right now it's 2, so in 9 years, you add 9, would be 11. It says that will be the same as the old dresser was 8 years ago. So 8 years ago, old dresser was what? Okay, so 19 now, 8 years ago, 11. And it says that they were the same, right? The new dresser 9 years ago was the same as the old dresser 8 years ago. I don't know if I just said that right. The new dresser in 9 years, 9 years from now, right? 9 years from now, the age of the new dresser, which is 11, is that the same as the age that the old dresser was 8 years ago? Yes, they were both 11. So it does check. So this is correct. The age of the new dresser is 2. The age of the old dresser is 19. By the way, if you would have done this whole problem over and let the old dresser be x and the new dresser be 21 minus x, you would have gotten the same answer. Your answer for x comes out different because you called x something else. But in the end, the new dresser should still be 2 and the old dresser would still be 19. So if you want to see what I mean, I'm just going to set that up so you could see how it would have been if you had changed which one you let x be. So here's the exact same problem. So what if I instead wanted to let the original variable be here for the old? I'm going to call it n just so you don't get confused and see the same variable x. So if this is n, remember this will be 21 minus n. And we needed to know the age of the new dresser in 9 years, so we would write 21 minus n plus 9, right? And that does simplify. We'll do that in a minute. The old dresser 8 years ago would be n minus 8. And then the directions were saying that 9 years ago, so this, the age of the new dresser 9 years ago, is the same as the old dresser 8 years ago. So if we set those two up together, we're going to get, let's see, 21 minus n plus 9 is the same as n minus 8. So 21 plus 9 is 30 minus n equals n minus 8. And I'm going to solve for n. So I am going to add n to both sides so that I have a positive number in front of the n. And I'm going to go ahead and add 8 to both sides. So I get 38 equals 2n. When you divide by 2, you get 19 is n, or n is 19. Okay, so this time you solve for the variable n, which was the age of the old dresser. So notice you're going to get the same answer. You're going to get the old dresser was 19, and the new dresser was 2, and the check would be exactly the same. So it doesn't matter if you let your variable be in for, just the single variable, either the x or n, be here for the new or the old. But if you do let the old one be x or n, then when you solve for it, you'll find out how old the old dresser was first. Where the first way I did it, I found out how old the new dresser was first. I found out that that was 2. Okay, so that was a little bit tricky, but fun word problem, don't you think? Or remember, puzzle. Fun puzzle. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.